about my professional background. Yeah.
Okay, like you have end-to-end knowledge on like SQL Server, SSRS, or you have done on moderate basis, how things that you have taken care?
So, I mean, initially when I started working on SSRS, I was a complete novice. I mean, I have no idea how to use SSRS, how to create an SSRS support. So, a few of my colleagues, they kind of like taught me how to create the reports. And instead of going for like the basic version of SSRS, as in like when you try to deploy the reports, use the report manager and you just send out to the users, we came up with a dashboard kind of a tool where you use images to navigate through each and every section. Let's say like every business have their own business module. So we created a dashboarding kind of a feel for the users within the SSRS report itself. So and I mean I can't say like I'm a, like an expert level in SSRS, but I would say I was like intermediate level.
Fine. So who does the back end thing for you in developing stored procedures, coding techniques and all?
That's myself. Yeah. I mean okay, I understand what you mean. So yeah, I used to create procedures for my reports, and I used to develop them and used to deploy them as well.
Good.
I'm well
Okay.
aware with SQL, so like completely entirely new to me.
Which one is pretty new?
Oh no, that's what I'm saying. Like SQL is not new to me.
Okay.
I've been working on T-SQL for about like 5 6 years, so that is quite I
Okay.
mean I'm quite
Okay,
handy
that's
with
quite
it.
handy for you.
Yes.
Fine. That's great to hear. And it's even interesting because you already have a fair knowledge on what is a reporting, what is a data backend, and you know what are the terminologies of warehousing, things like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. And how about the rest of the team? Srikanth,
Srinivas, myself, over 10 years of experience on business objects. So reporting on using web intelligence, desktop intelligence in business objects tools, and worked on crystal reports as well, and dashboarding on Excel CS.
okay.
So yeah, that's the main experience.
So most of the times that you have started implementing on reporting kind of on
Yeah.
reporting that you have used Excel, crystal
Yeah, I
reporting,
used
these all the
Excel.
tools.
Yeah, I used Excel also. Yeah.
Okay. So these are the two main things like crystal reporting and Excel.
Yeah, crystal reports, Excel, business objects. In business objects, we have got some different tools, web intelligence, desktop intelligence, these kind of tools.
So when you say business intelligence, you have used with respect to SAP or Cognos, anything?
No, it's an SAP tool, business objects.
Yeah, that's what business objects, that's what I was asking. You have used SAP.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Good. And how about your hands-on experience with database?
Database, not means I'm familiar with writing the queries and everything, but not complex stored procedures, these kind of things. So, but queries wise, I'm fine.
Okay. In general, like when you say that you have worked on reporting stuff kind of, so basically you will be
Yeah.
connecting each and every time to a database, or you will be getting data in a file system and you will be getting
It's
data
through
in
database only.
raw files.
No, it's through database only, but we create the universe layer in business objects. So in that universe layer, we create the object. So or when we create that, and when we connect to that universe in the reporting layer, the SQL is generated automatically. We drag and drop objects. So that's why we don't need to write big SQL statements when we use business objects.
Okay,
But I
fair
am
enough.
familiar with the queries and everything. Because at the
Okay.
end, when we do the testing and everything, we have to write the SQL queries to do the to test the reports.
Okay, you have done a multi-role, like you have done testing, you have done documentation, you have done development and reporting as well.
Yeah.
Fine, good to hear. So,
Okay.
how about you, Srikanth? Srikanth, are you audible with us?
I think he has got some problem, I think, hearing. Maybe I think he can hear. Yeah.
Yeah, he just activated his headset now.
Yeah.
Srikanth, you can disconnect and connect one so that you will have things better. I mean, are all of you three from a same perspective, or you three are individuals in general?
So, do you mean we know each other, or?
Yeah. Okay.
And coming to Srikanth, if I tell briefly about him, actually, he's new to the IT. So, he has done some testing courses previously, but. He has done testing also parallelly recently. So, but he is planning to move to Power BI as well. So that's why he's keen to learn this technology.
Okay.
So he's from non-IT background, I can say. Yeah.
Cool. So, coming back to myself. So myself, Sridhar. I have almost 9+ years of experience into database and business intelligence technologies like MSBI with the components of SSIS, SSRS, SSAS, and with the visualization concepts such as Qlik, which is like QlikView, Tableau, Power BI. I will be working as developer, I will be working as architect, both of it. And my role is based, most of the things will be in an initial phase of a project. I do all the architectural kind of functionality, how the things to be stabilized and how the project initiatives to be taken care, what all the kind of functionalities that are to be implemented within the project, each and every aspect of it, followed by next level when we move ahead at a low level. Once all the high level functionality has been designed, provided inputs, and then taken all the sign off, then we start moving into low level. Then we'll be handling a team, implementing kind of development activities, delivering things in terms of from the base of a scratch till to the end of a deployment, every aspect of things that I will be taking care of in terms of unit testing, documentation, deployment, all these respective. These are most about myself and all the technical skill set that I have. And when we say in terms of database, I have end-to-end functionality what we do in a Microsoft SQL versus T-SQL. And when we said like MSBI, I have taken care of solution implementation from end-to-end, from a scratch of raw file databases, whether it is a single or multilingual. And from there, processed each and every of the techniques, what actually that we require to get a end solution for that particular data level. We have migrated every sort of thing from data mart layer, staging layer, and then warehousing, all these things. From there itself, we move on depending upon the type of data, type of requirement, whether it is an SSRS or we need to build from warehouse, developing a cube, implementing a report, and then delivering it. And in terms of expansions, we have worked for multiple clients on multiple things in delivering, such as ClickView, in developing QVDs, delivering type of dashboarding, all these respective. Tableau, as we know that we have all the things such as a Handy, which comes in terms of dimensions, facts, and then calculation fields. Finally, in terms of Power BI, where we have started implementing all the kinds of data implementations we here started doing in different ways. In such a times, taking directly raw files and then processing it, sometimes we will be directly connecting from database, all these respective. This is more about myself before we initiate things.
Okay, so when you said, you know, from the scratch, did you mean you look into the hardware aspect as well?
It means like, suppose I being a client visited to your organization, I had some particular project to assign for you. Before I start assigning a project, I need to take care of the business requirements, what actually their needs are, first providing a initial solution, what actually as per their business, what can be provided as a initial kickoff, whether what actually that will be better needs for them. If they have specific criteria on their overhead that I want to do things only in this technical aspect in this particular way, if he is a techno-functional guy, we will be proceeding with him as per his thoughts. If not, he know only the business and he was expecting this output, whatever the things that we require, we can use of an implementation. In that case, either of the things I start involving into the calls, handling things, and then developing all the SOW, software requirement things. And from there, once our software requirements has been freezed, we take the business needs. And from there, what actually is the end functionality that we need to deliver, we start implementing the architect. How the data they have, what type of inputs they are going to give us, what will be the better solution for us to take and then put in a structured, organized format. And from there, what is the end functionality they were expecting? What could be the better way of approach in giving them depending upon the complexity of data that they have?
Okay. Let's say, like, you know, if one of your clients, you know, their need is to get into Power BI, so do you look into the architecture phase as well, like, you know, like to have a server to host the whole application, right? So do you look into the server side of aspect as well, or is it only the software side and, you know, building the data warehouse and other aspects?
So only on the development aspect that I will be taking. So all the server level capacity, the number of users and its maintenance. So what would be the better approaches and all? We even have a sort of senior database analyst with all the hardware specification required things and all. So they will be even involving to make sure what actually their complexity and how much is the functionality of the project that they hold. All these things they calculate and they maintain the server maintenance.
Okay.
So that's how things that we're taking care. Now, let's generally take a simple scenario and then try to make a workout at a high level to make sure what actually that it can be made. So as of now, I will be making you a generalized picture at a high level, what actually things can be. And on a deep level analysis, we can move ahead on a software requirements and things in a further going functional scenarios and all. So let me take a real-time need, which was nowadays very most popular with e-commerce. Let's take a business need of e-commerce and see how we can start making things and from an end to end, if that is the requirement, what actually that we need to do. Any idea on what is an e-commerce?
E-commerce is something like you have like a product with you and you want to sell it online. So you have a platform where you can do that. So the best example is Amazon, eBay.
Exactly. So, when we say in terms of e-commerce, we will be taking anything that we have nowadays. It can be Amazon, it can be eBay, it can be Flipkart, it can be Snapdeal, anything. So, client is giving me sources in different variants. So that different types of sources which they have provided, because each and every stakeholder, client or whatever that we have, we will be not relying to ask them, if you do only on this source, I will be considering your project. There can be anything from their end as per their need. So let's say people are using databases with respective to Microsoft SQL Server as a backend. And this is with respective to front end. Similarly, in the case of eBay, they have started using Java with Oracle. Flipkart, they have two things. They use PHP followed by MySQL or file system, and the file system can be Excel,
Excel, Word, it could be anything, yeah.
CSV, TXT, anything. And here, Snapdeal is being used with
HTML.
Basically, HTML comes into scripting and to do in terms of, okay, that's fine. And let's see in terms of backend, we have Teradata. So these are various things. Now, you were asked to prepare to analyze their respective data, whatever they have, in a functionalized format to make sure what is the competency between each and every e-commerce application. Nowadays, what happens is whenever you try purchasing any particular product through online, will you be directly going and validating in Amazon and you do a moving to cart and then making your payment gateway? No, right? Once you want a product, you will search here, 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 and some different sites. Finally, you will come to a solution. What will be your respective things that you are expecting? What gives you the best product of it? Instead, what the people are trying to make sure that time can be easily developed, if they have the differentiation of things in which they can have what is the, I mean, better features which they can find the difference in a third party website. What is the difference between Amazon, eBay of that product, which gives the better feature? What is the price of it? And what is the respective features, whatever it has? All this. So, who is going to make sure all these data is going to capture and give the competency instead of going through each and every e-commerce? Third party applications are coming into picture to make sure the difference, understanding, and the features of it. From there, we just go through that understand what will be the better, and directly we jump onto the main parent e-commerce and then start developing or doing sort of purchase whatever that we need. Right? Did you get my respective whatever I was saying?
Yep.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So in that case, how do you get that entire functionality into a third party application? How do you start building your dashboarding to display from a third party application about all these respective differentiations? What would be the better approach that you people will think of? If this is the business that I have trying to give for your organization, and I asked you people to develop this solution. Final end thing is, on a third party application, I need to see what will be the better approach of Amazon, eBay, Flipkart, Snapdeal. So that's what my final end result. How do I do in generalized or at a high level thing till now, whatever the reporting kind of development or implementations that you people have came across? So you people are good with the scenario what I have given, right? Or you have any confusion out of it?
So you want to have like a comparison site that gives you, so technically you should have access to the back end so that you know you can compare it.
Yeah, let's say today you are expecting to purchase a Porsche versus a Lamborghini. So how do you know that which will be the better for you, whether it's Porsche suits you or Lamborghini suits you? First, you will be finding out what is the difference between Porsche and Lamborghini of that specific model. Then it directly hits your Lamborghini website, or it directly hits your Porsche website, or it goes into a third party website and gives you the differentiation about it.
Okay, so when it comes to the third party website, what they'll be doing is they'll be taking the API, you get the data, and that does the comparison for them. That's so, my understanding. Yeah, sorry.
When you say API,
yeah,
how do you get that API? What is the source for it? Who start building out of it? What does that API consist of here?
The API is more like a compact, you know, data where you actually can access the database of that company. You know, they into kind of like, you know, sell it to the third party websites where they can buy the API and display the data however the way they want to. Let's say the best example is the airline websites. What they do is, you know, if you go to any of these third party airline websites, you know, they have all the information about the current flights and price and everything. So technically speaking, you know, no airline wants to just give the data just like that. And at the same time, these people, they try to buy off the data and then display in their website, and they pay some amount to the airline. That's how my understanding is, you know, that's how it generally works out.
So
please do correct me if I'm wrong.
In generally, when you say API,
yeah,
API is built in multiple situations. Let's say I was trying to implement a functionality from this particular component, whether it is RS, IS, or Cognos, anything. System is not having that functionality what I expect to do, like error handling, let's say, or I want to handle some specific event every time, which is not a part of system defined in that component. So I can develop an API, call that API within this source code, so that it can give me an additional component or additional criteria where I require this particular feature to be added in an error handling. And when we say API is connect to a direct source code or a data that we need, in that particular case, we can do things extracting what all the things that you want, instead of each and every time you connect either a file or whatever it is in, let's say my data is very huge that I'm going to handle and all this. You cannot directly connect all these multiple sources and make your server down and then report to be complicated. What we do, we optimize things, pushing every set of information, whatever we need, by using sort of ETL functionality and then finally loading it into one consolidated destination, which makes us that as a source going forward.
Okay.
So that it gives us an easier method. Instead of you connect this many number of things, directly you can connect for that single source of mechanism. You do whatever the complex operations that you want, developing the code by doing a stored procedure or a query mechanism, whatever that you need. And finally, you get the end result out of it and you can directly call within the outcome. And finally, you can do ad hoc calculations on the dashboard, display that. That gives you the more appropriate functionality.
Okay.
So these are multiple ways of things. Because when we say in terms of solution, whatever that I give, it's not a permanent solution, because sometimes in different situations, it works out. If it is not a complex dashboard, it's a very simple and it's a limited data. Whatever that you take, whether one is file, one is SQL, one is something else, something is manualized, everything is acceptable because data is not complicated and server is not going to take much burden out of it. That's where things are. But as per the scenario which we have discussed just now, if we want to implement that, the first and foremost thing is you need to check what is the complexity of your data. Because first, all your stakeholders should accept to provide into third party app as a competitor. Once everything has been done, this third party application is trying to get connected to all the sources of information, get the data, make sure that it is going to display. As I have told just now, it can be either complex or it can be either simple. So depending on things, either he can automize it into a warehouse and then consolidate it into a warehouse, or he can do a OLTP mechanism and do into a normal database kind of, or else if he is not even this much of headache things where he want to use all this, he will directly connect whatever that he get without doing any sort of data manipulation, whatever it is, because it has a capability of directly connecting any sources. 100 plus sources Power BI is acceptable to connect. He will start connecting, connecting, connecting. He will think of about optimization, performance and everything at a final endpoint, because he want as of now to connect, get things done. That's all. Whether it is taking smaller amount or larger amount of time, he is not bothered. Now, after making all these things, we know that we are now in a state of situation where you can connect for Amazon data, eBay data, Flipkart data, Snapdeal data. To make sure which is coming from what and what is doing you what, you will be having a sort of flags. So that, because I will have cost as a column in all these applications, how come I know that cost is specific from Amazon or any other e-commerce? When I start consolidating, my data will have a cost column, product column. Let's say your corresponding Lamborghini is a part of a sales from any of these e-commerce application, but which particular price of environment you are displaying is specific to Amazon, eBay, Flipkart, Snapdeal. How come I know the differentiation? There should be a flag behind to
the
that.
Flag, yeah.
So that the group of things that will be aggregated according to that e-commerce application wise with their data level, so that it gives you individual calculated result of what Lamborghini is going to make a sale out of it. Got it?
Yep.
Now, I'm with you. If everything, whatever that you want, is trying to compete, this is the way. Finally, This is what my third party application and its label was. He started extracting information from various kinds of source environments. And he started implementing what features that he need, he started implementing here. Now, whatever that you want, you got into this and you have started implementing the entire data. So you have started taking all these things which we discussed just now. Now, whatever my dev app requires, everything I have achieved. Finally, this I can directly connect to my Power BI now. Right? Instead of I do this many number of features, I can directly connect this one, right? Do you agree or you have any questions? Anyone among you?
Now you can do it.
Now, since he had things, whatever that he need from all the e-commerce, he can directly start connecting and he will start doing what all the dynamic features of calculations he require in terms of displaying what all the charts, visualization, detailed level of data display, or whatever the needs that he'd need of. So that's how you will be taking all the tiles individually, creating each individual report. Initially in each and every tab, what do you need? At a finally, you will be developing your dashboard, consolidating all these reports. So this report is nothing but called as in technical term as tiles in Power BI.
Mm-hmm.
So to develop all these tiles, you will be doing in between. So you have anyhow connected this data, you are going to get this, and here you are going to differentiate in terms of selecting your dimensions, measures, and if they are directly implementable, you will be directly dragging and dropping. No, in between you want to apply some sort of calculated features, you will be doing ad hoc calculations, dynamic features out of it, whatever the things that you want to do, all these things that you start building it and then taking care of. Got it?
Yep.
So this is how the end-to-end share that you will be doing in general. But as a part of current thing, which we are here to discuss only on this respective. only on this single piece, because these all things that you are already aware of how you will be doing and what is the way of getting things done.
Okay, so Power BI, do they, I mean, does the tool have something like a universe, like, you know, you have in Bevo or even in Cognos? Do you have something like the universe?
What do you mean by universe?
Like a framework where you actually can, you know, drag and drop things, or you need to, because, you know, SSRS don't have something like that. You need to write a query or a stored procedure to represent the data. But Cognos, they have framework, and business objects, they have their own universe where, you know, they can pre-calculate things and everything and just simply drag and drop within the report. So Power BI, does it have something like that, or that should be connecting to the database all the time? I mean, technically it should connect to the database all the time, but again, is there any place where you only can, like, you know, drag and drop things?
So as you have told, universe, even you take Cognos, even you take SAP BO, anything, you will be connecting first. Before you connect, you will be doing all your scratch work, what you need at a specific database level until a certain stage, whatever that you can do, right? And that you are going to connect as a connection string, data source, or whatever that you have as a technical term that we will be using it.
Yes.
Now, when you have connected and when you have received, there are few things which you cannot directly call that column and then display. Sometimes you want to even calculate two or more fields, or within the same field you want to define some different case conditions. Right? Even if it can be a Cognos or BO or SSRS, anything. But when you told in SSRS, you need to develop a data set with some defined logic. Whether it can be query, whether it can be function, view, stored procedure. Even here, you have a feature where you can directly connect to some raw data, whether it can be in a file system or directly to a database. It is acceptable. From there, either you want to directly implement your drag and drop feature, you can do that. Else, if you want to do all your data sort of scrubbing mechanism which you have, you can even do that and directly connect it. These are either ways that it supports.
No, what I meant is, when you look into SAP BO, where you actually have, you know, I mean, let's say you don't have any data warehouse or anything, and all you have is some data dump. So in Cognos, you have something called Cognos framework, where you actually do all the joins and everything within the framework. And, you know, when you try to create a report, you have everything structured, and, you know, all you need to do is drag and drop into the report directly, where it has got all the joins background. So that's what I'm checking with you. Does Power BI have something like that, or?
So these joins and all, has it done it automatically by itself, or you have taken different objects, you have mapped the relation, and you are directly connecting it, right?
Yeah, that is correct. And you know, let's say we got three developers, and, you know, all three developers log on to their reporting tool, and all three can see the same thing.
Yes.
So does Power BI have something like that, or
Here there are two things. Individual, group workspace, two things. So if you are working on a group, it can have multiple users working, and then you can have a shared facility.
Okay.
If you are working on an individual, it is only specific to you. You cannot have towards a different shade of environment that you want to give. And when you have told that Cognos has a feature where I give objects and I can give a relation so that it can do, you can do a drag and drop out of it. Yep. Here is also the same additional feature which it had. You can give all the objects you can prepare the relationship, and that we call it here as a data modeling. And that data modeling, once it is done, you can directly call and use what all the attributes in terms of dimensions versus facts.
Okay.
Got it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did I made you clear, or you got a sort of a generalized idea?
No. It is kind of clear. Yeah.
Okay. So this is what basically which we had, and we will be discussing more in detail and insights of each and every feature and functionality on step by step. That's how we will be moving.
Okay, so just out of curiosity, what are all the features that we'll be covering within the Power BI?
So all the kinds of report types which we have.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of geographical locational mapping, or you will have data level of display by using table or a matrix kind of reports, and you will have all the charts and the different types of reporting, and from there what all the type of calculations that you want, and how you can do a data scrubbing mechanism when any raw data is provided for you, and finally how do you develop a dashboard, and how will you deploy it?
Okay. So that's from like a report developer point of view. And do you show us like how to do the security bit as well? The administration and security?
No, that I am not going to take care of.
Okay. So I mean, you won't be showing us like, you know, how to create the groups or roles or anything as such.
Yes.
So are you going to show us, or are you not going to show us?
No, I will be just giving you only the development criteria.
Okay.
Understood?
What will be the sources you will be using to connect the data?
We will be using Excel and SQL.
Yeah. Excel and SQL, okay. So just you will be showing how we can do the dashboards and whatever the calculations, you will be showing the complex DAX ones or just the basic ones?
I will be giving you the intermediate level.
Intermediate level, okay. What about the access to the tool and everything, to the software?
So I will be sharing links where you can start downloading, and you can have this almost 6 months of trial version.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that you will be giving, right?
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
Because Microsoft has a facility where you can download any of their product, and it
but
supports 6 months for trial. The only thing is you need to have organizational mail ID for registering your Power BI.
Yeah, but that one is for 30 days, right?
Yes.
So that's only for 30 days, not for 6 months, I think.
Yes.
Okay. And how many days will be the course?
So it will be almost 30 to 35 hours of duration.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what will be the timings which you will be taking? Like, what's
so
your feasibility?
Timing wise, I will be updating to Prakash, because currently, if you can see, I was at midnight 1 a.m. in IST.
Yeah. I know that. So that's why I was asking, like, because it's very late for you.
Yeah, so I came to know that you stay 4 hours prior to me.
So yeah,
four and a half.
Yeah, I expect your early hours which would be my 10 or 11 a.m. in the morning. So that if it is my 11, you will be somewhere 7 a.m.
Okay.
Okay, just wondering how long the class will be? Duration of the class.
I can support for 1 hour, and depending upon the functionality of me and my work that I have around, I can even take for 1.5 hour a day.
No, the only reason I'm asking is, you know, if it is between, like, you know, 7 till like 9 or something, we need to go to work as well, right? So that's what we're just thinking.
I mean, you can even join at 6 a.m. if you are good, and you can wake up early. You can make things and you can complete. It's not like do it your 6 to 7 a.m., which would be my 10 to 11. And later you can immediately rush up, get ready, and you can pack up.
Okay. And is it going to be like a daily class, or is it going to be like the weekend class, or?
So I prefer for Monday to Friday. Because weekend I don't take much stress. I have my own personal things and all.
Yeah, yeah, definitely, definitely. I totally understand where you're coming from. Okay.
Anyway, we can see the timings later. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, and just wondering, could you send us the course content, any chance?
Yeah, I will be sharing it for Prakash because he holds your mail IDs. So he will share it with you later.
Definitely, yeah, that will be helpful.
Yep.
Perfect. So any other questions, guys?
No.
I will be winding up from my end, and Prakash will be having a short call with you people, and later he will be wrapping up.
Definitely, yeah.
Okay, so yeah. Prakash, you are available? Let me just give him a call. He might be drowsy. Hi guys, Prakash is gonna continue now, and I am going to wind up. Let's catch up in the next session. Okay.